但是从屏幕右端向屏幕的左端来进攻。上半场比赛凭借着贝里沙第20分钟的进球，墨尔本胜利做客是1-0，暂时领先于悉尼 FC。啊，这支的状态还是要高于悉尼 FC。虽然悉尼 FC 在很长的一段时间占据着场上控球方面的优势，但是这种优势很难能够转化为进球。前场，林科维奇。这些是传入到禁区之内，到后点，一球到中路，头球的攻门没有能够顶上，艾维还有二次进攻的机会，格兰特胸部的停球之后，直接置入到禁区之内，小范围的配合，奥尼尔稍作调整，外围的远射。绝杀呢，如果一旦双方战成平手的话，将会进行半个小时的加时赛，如果加时赛还
You look at goal fouls conceded more than double for Melbourne Victory, and they've done, you know, when Brisbane have regained possession, they've been very clever in stopping them from playing, not
the only goal when he looked unlikely in a two-on-one battle, managed to lob it over the top of Lawrence Thomas.I wonder if that's changed the goalkeeper dynamic tonight, whether McThomas will stay on his.
朱纳奇头球的一顶，墨尔本胜利的球员上抢的幅度并不是很大，这里啊，这球还没有出界，头球走到边路，还是想要和库比完成连线，然后直接是照到了双方的主教练，这个一顶英格汉姆，这一次对于球落点的判断，在接完球之后啊，场面上的局势完全是
Georgeski similar in the first half, the close of the first half.
Martinez with the corner. Cornthwaite, the obvious target given his height. Play. Didn't get the contact he wanted. It breaks for Scott Neville. Still plenty in the box for Western Sydney. Santalab throws himself at the ball. And then Thomas comes to claim.
A good move to the ball from.
Stoppage time we go, of which there will be 3 minutes.Again, Wanderers work it short. Martinez looking for Cornthwaite. Volley cleared by Troisi.
Supporters, of whom there is a growing army, but he bursts in those free spaces. He does it so well, really well. One of the most dangerous in the league at it. Not consistently dangerous enough from those shoots by Carter as a result.
Was a rash challenge, in fairness. Probably deserving of the yellow card.